everyone, it's Lisa, and today is Wednesday, hump day. Chanel has been laying over there the whole time, and now she's getting up, and I've been talking to her and everything. You just want to be on camera, don't you? Today, I thought I would do a quick video. It started out this morning. I went to swatch the Rosie Huntington Whiteley lip liners that Nisha sent me. I just picked them up on, goodness, Chanel. I just picked them up on, I guess, day before yesterday from the post office. And this morning I wanted to wear one. So I went to swatch them on my hand to wear one. I thought, you know, I'm going to go ahead and do a video and show all of you the different colors. She sent me all of them except for the red one because I just don't wear red lipstick that much. And I do have plenty of lip liners that would go with red. So, and I was going to just show you, I have a picture of it that I did, but I figured I would just go ahead and show you right now. And, okay, I want to keep her here, but I just don't know if I can because she's like right here. Okay, so the first one, and I think, I don't know if this is going to be my favorite one or my next to the favorite, but the first one I'm going to show you is RHW, which stands for Rosie Huntington Whiteley. And here they are. They're real pretty with the rose gold. And they are the roll up. And I almost made a boo-boo. I've done this with a NARS eyeliner before. Oh, you're just going to lay right on them? Okay. But they're the roll up. And I put it in the sharpener and you'll see when I turned it a little bit and then thought about it and realized it was the roll-up. So, anyway, this is the first one, RHW. Okay, and that is the one that I have on today. I think it's going to be my favorite. And I went ahead and put it with one of her lipsticks that Nisha sent me a long time ago when this line first came out, and it is called, it's Nude. Nude Mink. And so I'm going to put that right beside it so you can see the lip combination that I have on. I love it because it's kind of peachy. And then I felt like, you know, I always feel like I need a little bit of gloss right in the center. So I put on a little bit of Buxom Celeste. If you just put a little bit on, it just brings your, it's like putting salt on something. It just makes it better. It just brings all the taste together and makes it better. Okay, so that was RHW. Okay, this is the next one that I thought I might really like, and it's called Silk. And it looks like the next, okay, this is one that, see, it broke off when I tried to swatch it because I was probably going back and forth kind of hard. But this is Silk. And so you can see that it is darker, but still that good tone, kind of probably comparable to a little bit darker than Ideal and a little bit more brown. I don't know what to really compare that to. Maybe it's not as pink as Max Soar. Maybe Makeup Forever 3C, something like that. Okay, and then the next one is another nudie one, and this one is called Camisole. And this one is kind of light, but really pretty. This would be good for those of you that like MAC NSYNC or NARS Fantasia or MAC Naked, one of those that gives kind of like the light lip liner look. Or, NSYNC would be kind of close, but a little bit more wearable than NSYNC. Really pretty. Okay, so that was Camisole. And then the next one is Dolly. And I believe this is the brightest one. And I know one of her dog's name is Dolly. And this one broke on me too, but that's okay. We'll still give it a good swatch. Okay, so that last one is, Chanel's got my colors mixed up. Okay, so I think that one is, the first one is RHW, the second one is Lace, okay, the third one is Silk, okay, I believe this one is called Camisole, yeah, that's Camisole, because I remember Dolly was the brightest one, so that is Camisole. Chanel was laying on my last lip liner. She was laying on Dolly. And this is the problem. I don't see the name on the lip liner, which is so weird. I don't know if there's a number. I don't know if the number corresponds to it, but I don't see the name on the lip liner anywhere. Let me see if it's up here at the front. No. Hey, she is just staring at me like, hey. Hey, I'm gonna take a picture of you right now with all the stuff on my table. Okay, so sorry, this is the last one and it is Dolly. Now this is Dolly, the one named after her puppy dog. Okay, and you can see it is the brightest one. So see, they're all very, very wearable colors. I think the first two are gonna be my favorite. I think I will wear all of them, especially in the summertime with a little bit lighter, you know, or the brighter lips. Think how good, too, like Dolly will look with that new Chanel lip liner. Subtle. Very pretty. And Camisole is more of that, kind of like if you like Natural Mauve by Lancome or the Too Faced Perfect Nude Liner. They're all just so pretty. Okay, so thank you so much, Nisha. And then let me show you the other things that she picked up for me. She picked up some things, she said, to help me with my wing. Here, let me read what she said. She's also put in a couple little extra things for me, she said, that may be good for your wing. She has not tried the eyeliner, but it looked interesting, and the little cotton buds are liquid filled, so you can are good for cleaning up. Those are, I have thought so many times that I need to get those. I think Ponds or somebody makes those. So she sent me some of these cotton buds to help with my wing, which I always need help. I don't think a day goes by that I don't have to alter one side or the other. And then this is the eyeliner that she got me, and I love trying new eyeliners. And it is by Ciate. I'm sure I'm pronouncing that wrong, but it is the Chisel eyeliner. So let's check. Oh, it's got that daggone plastic wrapping. Let's see how hard it is to get it off, because a lot of times I have a hard time. You know what these ones like Makeup Forever lip liners come with this on there. And I think maybe NARS does too. And I have the hardest time. I usually have to go get the tweezers. Oh, I think I'm gonna get it. Okay, I started it. Okay, so here it is, the Chisel eyeliner. Ooh, that is neat. Let's see, I'm gonna put it over my face so maybe you can see it. See how it has like the really cool tip? That is neat. I bet I am going to love that. Look, so you can do it thick to thin really, really easily. Thank you, Nisha. I bet I'm gonna love that. I love how black it is too. Oh, and one thing I wanted to mention too is when I originally did these, all of that plastic is sticking to me. It's like staticky, I can't throw it away. But one thing I wanted to say too, when I went to take off the original swatches that I did, Bioderma or the L'Oreal Bioderma knockoff that I'm using would not take it off. I had to use my Shiseido eye and lip. So these lip liners are very, very long wearing. That's probably why usually long wearing lip liners end up being the ones that roll up. Now Lancome, you do sharpen and those are long wearing, but these I would say are comparable to the MAC long wearing lip liners. So I just wanted to show these to you. And thank you so much, Nisha. That was so sweet. And I love that I felt like, I mean, just to be comfortable enough to ask you, I really appreciate it. It made me feel good to be able to do that. So I'm gonna go take this off my hand and then do a quick outfit of the day. My kids have half a day of school today. They have teacher work day. So I need to get out of here and go to the post office and do some things I need to do and then go get them. So I'll be right back. Okay, so today I have on a dress that I got a while ago at Oliver. And the first time I wore it, I just felt like it looked terrible on me. I felt like I looked like a Teletubby because I felt like I was too big for it. I think last time I tried to put it with a belt, I'm not sure, but it is the, oh gosh, I can't remember the name of it. I don't know if it's the, I think it might be the cashmere one. I think it might be, but anyway, I know that it was on the on sale list that Oliver had, and that's what made me think about it. And it's kind of long and straight, but it has kind of like a high slit and it's very snuggly and comfy. And then I wanted to put it with something kind of plain, so I just put it with these little plain Stuart Weitzman booties. They're the high tines. I don't know if you can find these anymore. I'll look and see. Okay, and then for accessories, I have on the same bracelet. I haven't been taken off. And then I put on this because what made me think about this is when Sheila designed, I believe it's called the Nivea bracelet and necklace, she designed this for me because I had seen a Rosie Huntington Whiteley Page jeans ad that had a thick, chunky link necklace, and I showed it. Anytime I see something that I love, I send it to Sheila Foschel, and a lot of times she'll design something for me. And this is the one where I showed you the little video of them individually in Brazil, sitting there individually crimping each link by hand. It's amazing to see how much work goes into each piece. And it's, even though it's big, it's very light. That's the secret of her jewelry, is she makes everything very, very light. So that's what I have on, and no ring. And I was trying to think of something simple, so I just put in these little CZ studs. I think I might have some gunmetal Lilu studs upstairs. I'm not sure, but I just threw these in real quick. And so I hope you guys have a good rest of the week, and thank you for watching, and I will see you here on Friday. I've got lots of good stuff. Some of it's sitting right here, and I'll see you.